Welcome back, guys. This is Neo Kenshin coming to you with the final chapter of our DuckTales Remastered playthrough. In the last chapter, we completed the last stage of the moon, collected all 5 treasures, and found out that Magica has now taken the treasures to Mount Vesuvius along with Huey, Dewey, and Louie. So basically right now, Scrooge has teamed up with his nemesis Blomgold in order to try to rescue his boys. So pretty much now, we've come to the brand new final episode, which is definitely new to the game. Mount Vesuvius is a completely brand new level that was designed, and it looks beautiful. Pretty much, you know, pretty much Scrooge is in a volcano going after his boys. The theme is all brand new, specifically made, you know, for this game. And it's fantastic. And Mount Vesuvius is going to throw just about anything and everything at you in this game. You'll probably see just about every enemy there is. There's spikes. You got spikes. You got the skeleton ducks. It's all here. They pretty much took no expense in, you know, making the final stage as big and as bad as it can be. So here we go. All right. Just up here. Nope. Get rid of you. And I've realized I shouldn't have done that because I needed to get that chest. Oh well. Crap. One of these, yeah, here we go. So one of these chains takes you up top.
More money for me, money bin.
You kind of have to either use a short hop to kind of trick the bats, or do something, because they do not play fair. I walked into that.
Put your back into it,
McDuck. And then, of course, through the whole thing, you got Scrooge and Gloomgold fussing each other like a bunch of old men.
You go first.
I didn't get to be number one by back and boom. Oh, no, you don't.
Okay. Now we get to kind of the dark area. This is kind of an interesting area where, you know, you got no light and all you see is the silhouettes, which is pretty cool.
I'm going old, just not as old as you.
Oh, shut up!
I'm going as fast as I can.
All right, that helps. Yeah, I know I could have went further, but, you know, I just wanted to knock out as much of that stuff as I could. I can drop you. You. Alright, come here. Get rid of you. Get the $50,000 diamond. Alright. Now, first of all I gotta say is, for an old guy, Glumgold's got pretty strong there holding up a boulder like that. I ain't gonna lie. Right here, you gotta be careful, because you will have a boulder come through, and I think those boulders are instant kill, so it's best just to be careful here, though you can pogo jump off them. Good cake. Okay, hide under here. Of course, you can still bounce off the spikes, but if you need to, bounce off the rock.
I'm helping like you asked. Quit complaining.
Who's complaining?
Yippee!
pretty much you do need Pogo Jump off the rock to get the chain there. And I believe this is the final secret hidden area in the game. With extra money. Final minecart run. Just take your time, don't try to rush it, of course, to get the last one.
Get a move on, that gun!
True. Alright. That, of course, is a cart there, but you can go down here and take another one, and that'll net you a little bit more treasure. Up top, so you find that a bit better of an investment. Ah, missed him. If you time your jump right at the end, you can actually get both of those red diamonds. Alright. And we've got a run here. Basically just keep moving. And then we got the ghosts. So they decide to make a final appearance. Need be kind of stay up and trick them. That way you let them get going. Ah, crap. I mistimed that one. Okay. Just keep moving. Yeah, running's actually a bit easier. Oh, come on! I made that jump! Okay. Ah, crap. Okay, here we go. There we go. This way. And we'll net two red diamonds and a yellow. And that'll actually bring us down here. Final cake, I believe. Final diamond. Now, time to take on the final boss.
It took you long enough to catch up. What's the matter? Gold bricks in your caboose?
Oh, shut your beak. You're not getting any younger yourself, you old windbag.
Hush! Magica may not know we're here yet. We don't want to lose the element of surprise.
You kind of lost that earlier.
You have decided to deliver Dime after all.
Release my nephews, you evil enchantress.
Oh, not until you show me number one Dime.
Here it is. Now let the boys...
What? It's been great doing business with you, Scroogey.
Cheap double-crosser.
You've been in cahoots from the beginning.
No, even before beginning. Do you remember who sold your painting?
So technically, the whole thing was Magica's plan.
No wonder it was such a bargain.
$5 painting for you saved expensive treasure hunting expedition for me. And now, at long last, I am ready to use...
Well, I mean, hey, it actually ties everything up from the original NES game, you know?
With the smoke and mirrors routine. You've got my dime. Now release the lads.
Oh, boo-hoo. No time for buyer's remorse from old Hagman. Better to stick with master plan. Is much more exciting. I now summon Dracula Duck. Behold! Dracula Duck, I, Magica the Spell, have summoned you to do my bidding. You must obey my will and mine alone.
So now we see where Dracula
and
Duck came from in the first game.
You destroy this meddling
old... Alright. And of course, we close it off with an epic boss theme. And of course, Dracula is actually too high for you to hit normally. So, you have to bounce off him, and each time you hit him, Magica will actually summon a he'll go back to the background and she'll summon a power up for him. Of course, one of them is giant form, I think, for yellow. For red, he turns into a big swarm of bats, and you have to kind of watch out. You basically have to find the empty space. It doesn't fall until you get close to the empty space, so you kind of have that to work with. So you have to be real careful, because I'm making a lot of mistakes here. So, if I'm right, yellow, so yeah, when you see him throw a yellow, when you see her throw a yellow bag, that means Mega Dracula Duck. A red bag is bats, and green will turn him into a giant dragon, where he starts flinging fireballs. Basically, just kind of time your walk, and normally you shouldn't get hit. Unfortunately, I did. Ah, crap. Okay.
Give me ultimate power.
So we got bats. Oh dang. Okay. Shut back up. Okay, now, since he's higher up, you now have to bounce off two of them to get to him, which kind of ups the ante. Alright, now Super Dracula Duck. With Dracula Duck, if you go as far as possible to the sides, you can actually make him go off the screen. And that will actually kind of help avoid his chomp. One, two, gotcha!
Alright.
So, dragon. Ouch. Okay. One, two, gotcha! There we go. Dracula is toast.
Oh, boys. I'm so glad you're all right.
We knew you'd say that.
Yeah, we knew you would.
Now, we gotta go get the dime.
Launch pad will be waiting to take you to safety.
What about you, Uncle Scrooge? Yeah, the whole place is falling apart!
Magica and Glumgold still have my number one dime, and I'm not leaving without it. You boys get going.
Good luck, Uncle Scrooge!
And now, in the NES version, the final chase was, of course, climbing a rope to get to the top of a platform, which, in all honesty, unless you just really did nothing, you were always going to beat Magic. You were always going to beat Magic and Glumgold up there, because they flew slow as crap. So, however, the guys at WayForward said, that's too easy.
Oh, no, you don't, Missy!
So now,
let's go, you fool.
It's actually a real race to get to the dime. So you've got all kinds of You now have all kinds of crap obstacles to get through, and you've got to move. I mean, shoot. But you don't want to panic. I mean, if you keep calm, you will actually do pretty well. But, that's not it. That's not over. Just because you got the dime doesn't mean you're in the clear.
Have a lovely time together.
Because now, you gotta escape the volcano. Like I said, just keep a calm head. The the chains will break, but you know, if you stay calm, you pretty much are fine. And once you get to this platform, there you have it. And with that, you have just completed DuckTales Remastered.
The number one dime returns safe and sound.
But Uncle Scrooge, well, what about the treasure?
Yeah, we had it and we lost it. Sorry, Uncle Scrooge.
Come on now, boys. We may not have got to keep the treasure, but we had the adventure of a lifetime. And best of all, we got to share it together. You, Webigail, Launchpad.
And Duckworth, too. Don't forget about Mrs. Beakley. And Bubba. And Benton. And Gyro. They helped us, too.
Indeed they did, lads. Now, come on. Let's head for home.
And literally, it ends just like the end of an actual DuckTales episode.
Let go of me, you doddering old deadweight.
Oh, pipe down, you mangy bird.
And of course, we get to find out what exactly happened after all this. Turns out Scrooge still remains the richest duck in the world, and Glumgold gets arrested for what he did.
It was real swell of you to give Glumgold a lift home, Mr. McD.
Yeah, lift home in the back of the paddy wagon.
I'll put it on your bill, Flinty. You can pay me back in, say, 3 to 5 years. With interest, of course.
I'll get you for this, McDuck.
He charges interest.
Now, there's a sight I never get tired of. Come on, lads. Let's head to the ice cream shop.
Hey, can we each get our own cone this time, Uncle Scrooge?
Oh, why not? I'm in a generous mood today. In fact, each of you can even get a cone with ice cream in it.
Dang! He's that cheap? Wow. There you have it. DuckTales Remastered. In all honesty, this game, if you never played one of the classic Disney Capcom games, this is a great game to kind of introduce you to that that series. The original game was a very fun platformer, had a lot of great fun elements, a lot of challenge to it. It wasn't very stale at all. You know, you really had to kind of actually practice that game to get good at it. And the WayForward team taking this game and turning it into this, honestly, every single person who is a fan of DuckTales, the cartoon and the game, they were treated with so much respect with this game. The guys at WayForward, they honestly listened. They took an already phenomenal game and amped it up so much more that they put so much in it. The art style, the backgrounds, everything's so colorful. Like, in my opinion, it's like they decided to write their own episode of DuckTales based on the game. And you know, they took the elements of the game, and they literally turned it into an actual cartoon episode the way it plays out. And it's amazing. The fact that they got nearly all of the original cast for the original voices, you know, they made the gameplay so smooth, they made it really fun. The music, they did excellent on the music. All the remixes to the music was just wonderful. In all honesty, this is a game that you do need to buy. I believe it's probably still selling for $14.99 in the PlayStation Store, on Xbox Live. It's on Wii U. Do yourself a favor and get this game, because you will not be disappointed at all. To the guys at WayForward, I say thank you, because you took a game that I loved playing when I was growing up, and you made it 10 times more phenomenal. So, my final thoughts, I was really happy to play this game. I had a lot of fun with it, and hopefully I hope you enjoyed it as well. For anybody out there, here's hoping. WayForward, you did a hell of a job on DuckTales. Please, if you can get your hands on Chippendale's Rescue Rangers or Darkwing Duck and do this, you know, if you take those games and turn it into something like this, let's just say you're going to have a whole lot of people who are just going to love you for days on end. So with that, I want to say thanks, guys, for coming with me on this journey through to Duckburg and back, and I will see you guys next time. This is Neo Kenshin saying thanks for watching. I'm out, guys. Take it easy.